Hi guys, one of my most appreciated videos so far is my gym video. If you haven't watched it yet, then maybe go and check it out. If you've already seen it, you might have noticed there's a few similarities between my gym and Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. And I admit I was inspired by that very book. But I didn't want to make it too much like a Wonderland gym, because that would just be ripping it off. However, it certainly would make a really cool gym. And there are other fairy tales that would also make really awesome gyms. Okay, you know what? This is just too cool. Let's make up some fairy tale inspired gyms. First, let's head back to Wonderland. My personal favorite part in books, as well as in most adaptions of the story, is the mad tea party. And we're not just drinking tea at this party, oh no. Oh look, you got smaller. What a surprise, right? But to keep it more canon to the Pokemon world, we can just say the building is really, really big. And the furniture and everything is big. You get it. Anyway, you have to navigate your way through this giant, crazy table of tea party goodness. It's a bit of a labyrinth puzzle. You have to climb up on teacups and push down sugar cubes to be able to climb up on spoons and whatever. And of course, you have to battle the gym trainers before finding the leader. First out, we have the sleepy Dormouse, who is human, but they use mouse-like Pokemon. There's a variety of mouse-like Pokemon to choose from, so let's just say it's Cyndaquil, because it looks sleepy, and maybe Marill and Pikachu for some type variation. I don't think this gym would be an early gym, as it's a bit complicated. Maybe somewhere around the 5th gym. So these Pokemon would be around level 30 to 35. As you noticed, the gym is focused on themes rather than a type. And these trainers are more like mini leaders than random gym trainers. The second gym trainer you have to meet is the Marchair trainer. Their Pokemon will obviously be focused around rabbit-like Pokemon. I went with Bunnelby and Lopunny just because they're cute. And they look happy and fun, so it suits Wonderland. Just like the Dormouse's Pokemon, these are around level 30 to 35, but maybe on the higher end of it, just to be a little bit stronger than the Dormouse. So you beat the Dormouse and the Marchair. Now you get to climb the giant cake to meet the most mad gym leader you've ever met, the Hatter. As the gym leader, they have the strongest Pokemon, around level 40. The first Pokemon you battle is Gengar, who's bringing you some of that madness with its constant use of Confuse Ray. And it looks a little bit like a cat with its creepy smile and pointy ears, so you know where that came from. And the second Pokemon is Scolipede. It's just a nod to the hookah-smoking caterpillar in Wonderland. And lastly, you battle Hunchcrow, because no other Pokemon has a hat that fabulous. And the badge you get when you win is shaped like a teacup. I was choosing between a teacup or a hat, but I think a teacup represents the gym as a whole better than a hat does. Cause it's not just all about the Hatter, it's about all of them. So that's the wonderful Wonderland gym, but what other fun fairy tales can be turned into gyms? You'll have to wait to find out, so subscribe to my channel so you don't miss it. And maybe leave a comment in the comment section if you think there's a concept I should turn into a gym, cause I really enjoy making these videos. Thanks for watching, everyone, and stay awesome!